You ready? Okay, put that, dump that in there quickly. Get out of the way. And we go, underwater fireworks.
Kill the lights for me tonight.
This is cooler with the lights on. Not many chemical reactions that run at room temperature, and particularly not ones that can run strongly enough to generate heat and light underwater at room temperature. But we just used what you learned today in order to generate chlorine gas. And that chlorine gas coming out of there was reacting with the other bubbles that we made over there. Those other bubbles, get the lights for us, Brian. The other bubbles were acetylene. Acetylene like you'd run a cutting torch with. And acetylene, when it burns with chlorine, acetylene is C2H2. What are we gonna get as a result when acetylene burns? But remember, it's not burning with oxygen. C2H2. If it was a hydrocarbon burning with oxygen, what would we get?
Carbon monoxide.
Maybe carbon monoxide. What else?
H2O.
H2O. What else? I'll give you a hint.
Carbon.
So what you're seeing at the top is carbon that's unreacted. And if you were noticing, you might have seen bubbles like this one, black bubbles floating to the surface. It reacted in the bubble, but it didn't react completely. It reacted and gave us carbon. It didn't go all the way to carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. In this case, it would be carbon tetrachloride or carbon dichloride. But we also got a lot of just carbon completely unreacted. And at some point you might have noticed a little flame come across the top. And that flame was some acetylene that reacted not underwater but up here in the atmosphere. And then we also produced some carbon dioxide and some carbon monoxide. So that's underwater fireworks. Yes? Is it worth doing again for somebody else?
Yeah.
All right, good. Thanks.
Sounds good.